your most like iconic bit? Would that be taking a shit in the toilet at the hardware store?
Yeah, that would be my most iconic bit, written by Whitey McConaughey.
All right.
Whitey wrote that. How crazy is that?
Nice, dude. Yeah.
Who's Whitey McConaughey?
He's a snowboard guy.
Yeah, a snowboard videographer.
Okay.
Cinematographer. I think he's cinnamon or sugar or something. Photographer.
See? Exactly. That's how creative he is, dude.
It wasn't the shitting at the hardware store. Wasn't it like you showed up the first day, but your pants on the way there or something?
No, yeah. There was too many customers in there to clear them all. So they're like, wait, wait, wait. And I guess it was just a really busy day at the hardware store. And I'd already had this hot sauce that, like it's a ticking time bomb in me. So they're like, hold on, hold on. 3 hours went by, and we're in the van waiting outside, and it's like raining and wet, and then Tremaine starts, you know, jabbing me in the ribs. I'm like, seriously, dude, I'm not joking. I'm going to shit my pants. And so they had the heater blasting. It's all like moist and humid, you know, from the rain. And then when that shit, like three people puked out of the van load of people in there.
There was a bit. There wasn't a lot of stuff that we filmed where it's like, you know, yo, we can't show this, you know, like MTV just shoots it down. Like, we will not show this. I had like where I got branded a heart over my heart. Like, they let us film it, but then they were like, no, there's no fucking way we can show it. And that never got shown.
Oh, really?
Very little things what that I ever got.
What did we see of you then that you got branded?
Yeah, because I've seen that footage.
It came out like on like something like, oh, like after. Like, it was never allowed on TV.
I see.
Never allowed on TV. But the fucking... The one that Dave had, which wasn't allowed on, and ultimately it did end up getting on, but it was like in the vault, and it was fake poo.
I know.
The idea was the poo diaper.
Dave, yeah.
He just took a fucking chocolate pudding, put it in a diaper, and stashed it in a trash can, like where there's a bunch of people.
And then I asked them for change. You know, I was like, doesn't take much for me to look like a homeless guy. So I was looking like a homeless guy, like, oh, do you have any change? No one would give it to me, so I dug in the trash.
I'm so hungry.
I dig in the trash, and there's a plant. We planted a diaper in there with, you know, pudding, and I ate it out of the diaper.
I'm so hungry.
Was
I'm
that
so
hungry. My favorite was the one guy goes, yo, homeboy, that's a diaper.
Yeah. That's a diaper, dude.
Was that your idea?
No, homeboy. Yeah, that was one of my ideas.
And was that before pooping in the hardware store?
Like, oh, yeah, that was during our that was like the last few episodes of our TV show before that movie.
Okay. What's your infatuation with shitting?
Right. Wait, no, wait, but that wasn't shitting. It was just pudding.
Right.
But then MTV, you know, we filmed it and it turned out really funny. And then MTV's like, there's no way we're putting that on TV. It's too gross. It's just pudding, you know. But anyway, right. So Knoxville, from what I understood, I could have this wrong, but he said, I quit if you don't put that on TV. So they're like, okay. That's we put true. It on. And then he goes, I quit anyway.
I think that the one that he said he would quit was like, it was his cousin or something. And his cousin, he had footage of his cousin where it's like, you know, I'm going to fart or something. And it was called the accidental poop. Like some of his nephew, some family member. And he goes to fart and like a poop comes out. And I think Knoxville really went to war to get that on TV.
Yeah. So, did it make it on TV?
Yeah,
I don't remember that
I think
one.
So.
Because MTV won't allow shit at all, right? Or Paramount or anybody won't allow shit.
I mean,
because,
like, dog shit.
Yeah, but no, but like dog shit, right? But like.
But then in the movie, we were able to do real
shit. Chris Rapp was
Well, yeah.
Chris Rapp was allowed to fucking like run full speed taking his shit, right?
Yeah. I don't know where they draw the line. Yeah.
He ran full speed and took a shit.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. It was based on a George Carlin joke.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where did that air?
On the TV show?
Maybe we just saw that on a CKY video, though, and it wasn't on TV at all.
I definitely saw it on CKY. I don't know if it was on.
Yeah, I don't know if it made it, but I thought it did.
He ran as fast
I think it did. I swear I think it did. But then once we hit the movies, then it was like, I've taken a shit in every movie we've made so far. Like a real shit. This real shit, everybody. Right. We didn't fake it.
Yeah, you've taken a shit in every movie.
Well, my question is,
Wendy, it was real.
When and how? Like, when did you become the shit guy? Was it
high school? Was it college? Because
you're sort of known for shitting. When did that
happen? I remember, like, there was like a field behind my neighborhood where all the kids would play, and nobody wanted to play with me ever. And I remember back then when I was a kid, the Gatorade bottles were glass. So okay. I shit in really big mouth. So I shit in the glass Gatorade bottle and threw it on a stump in the backfield there with all the kids there. And the glass went everywhere and the shit smashed on the stump. And then from then on out, like, I was cool.
Wow. So then when you got Jackass, you're like, oh, shit, because that'll make me cool here. That's worked for me.
I was surprised. They're like, you can just shit whenever? I'm like, yeah. Like,
you can just shit whenever?
To me, it didn't seem like a big deal. Yeah, I could shit in front of someone way before I could pee in front of them. Like, wow. Easily, yeah.
And originally, it was Chris Pontius who was the shit guy.
He did the Pucano, right?
Right, because in the Big Brother video,
he did it. And I've always, yeah, so he did the first Pucano. I think Dave Carney wrote it, and then Chris Pontius did it. But, like, they did it all wrong. He, like, laid down, and the poop went sideways. It didn't turn out right. And ever since then, that was, like, mid-90s. And
you thought that was wrong? I thought that was fucking genius.
It was still awesome, but I'm like, it was amazing. If you're going to call it a Pucano, it needs to be looking straight up. No, yeah, let me rephrase that before I get beat up by Chris.
No. It's fine. And, I mean, if anything that I thought, it was just that you saw that it was an enema. Like, the water came out, and then the, you know.
Yeah, I was all ready to do mine. So I've got my legs over this way, and then my butt up this way, and I'm like, okay, guys, I'm ready to go. I'd carefully planned, like, for 1 month I didn't drink any caffeine, and then to that day I ate as much as I could and drank two giant Red Bulls, and so I'm laying up there ready to go, and they're like, one more thing, and I'm, you know, they got that whole train set thing over me.
This was for Jackass 3D, Pucano,
and so I'm all ready to go, and they didn't tell me they had this plan. Then Pontius comes up with an enema. He's like, I'm like, no, Chris, I'm good. I'm like, seriously, dude, don't put that in me. It was pretty rough. No, but whatever, he's my friend. He's allowed to do that if he thinks it's necessary. And he did it. So if you watch it, you can see I kind of just shot the water out separately because I can.
He penetrated the
apartment. You can switch
got rid
chambers.
Of that. You'll see it. Like, some water goes out, then all the shit comes out.
Wait, so can you fart on command?
No, okay. But you can shit right now if we wanted you to.
Yeah, do you want me to?
So did you have the opening scene for one of the Jackass movies where you shit on the toilet, like the little dollhouse toilet?
Yeah, that was a great one.
Yeah,
that one,
I did the fire hose rodeo in part two. So and then I slammed my ass super bad and went to the hospital. They gave me some painkillers, so I took them. And then the next day, they're like, let's do this, your idea with the little toilet. We have the whole thing set up. And I'm like, guys, like, the pain pills, I can't take a shit. And so they're like, let's try it anyways. So, you know, everyone's, all the cameras are on me. I'm trying as hard as I can. And you know, I don't know, like, pain pills, I think it's pretty much for everybody. They constipate you. Yeah. Like, even though I'm a professional shitter, come on, I'm human. So, but this is what happened. So I want this footage, by the way. I got to find this. I took a shit that was proportional to the little toilet. Like, a little shit that was, like, the right size for the toilet. And they're like, oh, forget it. And they went to throw it away. I'm like, ah! And I grabbed it. I'm like, I'll clean it out. I'll hang on to this, and I'll bring it, and we'll film it. So, like, I kept it with me, and then we were at Knoxville's house one day. I'm like, hey, can we do this? And they're like, let's do it.
Guess what? I have the number 30 ranked hot sauce on all of Amazon. It's called Steve-O's Hot Sauce for Your Butthole. And if you go on Amazon and type in Steve-O's Hot Sauce for Your Butthole and order yourself a bottle, you'd be really helping me. Because right now we're ranked number 30 on all of Amazon. And if you buy a bottle, we might go up the ladder. And that would mean a lot. So please, get on Amazon and buy Steve-O's Hot Sauce for Your Butthole. Yeah.
Yeah, dude.